Today on Rooted Daily, we talk about weak roots. Welcome to Rooted Daily, the podcast where in 10 minutes or less each day, we root you in the Bible so you can grow with God, you can weather the storms of life, and you can bear fruit. I'm Brandon Levy, and today we are talking about how we can grow strong roots and what can only sustain weak roots. Now, we've obviously spent a little bit of time about this already, about where we should lay our foundation. We've read from Matthew chapter 7, the Sermon on the Mount, where Jesus said, "Therefore, whoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who built his house on the rock. And the rain descended and the floods came and the winds blew and beat on that house and it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock. But everyone who hears these sayings of mine and does not do them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And the rain descended and the floods came and the winds blew and beat on that house and it fell, and great was its fall." And we need a strong foundation, and we need that in the Word of God. If we don't have those roots, we may be able to stay standing for a little while, but when the storms of life come, we will fall. Plain and simple. So we sit here for 10 minutes every day because we want to know and rely on God's absolute truth rather than our own subjective opinion. But today, I want to talk about when we blur the lines. And this happens more often than we like to admit, I think. We open up the Word of God and we use it as a tool to feed our curiosity rather than reading it just to understand the truth. We go down these rabbit holes of scripture, not because we think that they're going to give us some important truth that's going to change how we serve God, but just because we're curious. And it's not in scripture, but I think they're right when they say that curiosity kills the cat. We need more than curiosity to be Christians. Stephen, he didn't allow himself to be stoned because he was curious. Paul, he didn't allow himself to be imprisoned because he was curious. Peter, he didn't leave his life behind to follow Christ out of curiosity. An interesting section of the Gospels is where Jesus says that we should cut off a hand before we let it cause us to sin and gouge out an eye before it leads us to hell. I'm never going to do that out of curiosity. Only conviction will lead me to be that radical and that faithful. The temptation, though, I think this applies to preachers and teachers, and when you're leading Bible studies most of all, is to encourage speculation rather than that conviction we need. Quite frankly, because it's pretty interesting to speculate. We want to think up something new and different and revolutionary. And here we are reading this book that was written centuries ago, and it's been studied more than any other book in all of human history. And we have to realize there aren't many new things to find. Yeah, I'm not talking about application here. There are infinite number of ways we can apply scripture, but it seems like mankind has been asking the same question for 2,000 years, and God has maintained that we just don't need to know for sure. They're interesting to think about, but our curiosity about those questions isn't helping us any. And there's lots of questions that we have about the Bible, and the possibilities for them are really interesting. We can think of some. For instance, was Paul a widower? Does that mean he had a wife who left him when he became a Christian? Does that mean he has children? Or did Christ appear in the time of the Old Testament? And if so, when? Was he walking in the garden when it says in Genesis 3:8 that God was walking there? Was the fourth person in the fiery furnace Christ in Daniel 3:25? What about creation? How did that all happen? What's the science behind it? How did we go from two people to billions? And who wrote Hebrews and why? What was the thorn in Paul's flesh? Or when is Christ going to return? And don't get me wrong, those are all really interesting. In fact, I'm having a hard time not throwing in some of my opinions into the ring on these. Some of them have decent arguments on one side or the other. We can look and we can make good educated guesses on some of them. And that's okay. We're allowed to have opinions. We can even make that our hobby if we like. But it won't work as the foundation of our faith. For instance, There are some really great scholars out there who study the origins of life from a biblical perspective. They have evidence that God created the earth in 7 days and that it happened how the Bible describes it all. And that is incredible. But it's not the foundation of our faith. It's meant to bolster our faith. It's meant to build us up in that faith and prepare us to give a reason for the hope that we have. But it's not our foundation. Speculation, even good speculation, will not be enough for us to give our lives for God. If that's the only place we are growing our roots, then we're going to have a weak faith. You know, the bottom line is the Bible is interesting on its own. It is sufficient on its own. It doesn't need our speculation. You know, here's what Paul said about this to the Thessalonians about it. In his first letter, he writes, "I don't want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep," meaning died, "lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. Therefore," in verse 18, "comfort one another with these words. But concerning the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I should write to you, for you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so comes as a thief in the night. For when you say peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them as labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they shall not escape. But you, brethren, are not in darkness, so that this day should overtake you as a thief. You are all sons of light and sons of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who get drunk are drunk at night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and as a helmet of the hope of salvation. For God did not appoint us to wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. Therefore, comfort each other and edify one another, just as you also are doing." So the Thessalonians here, they are interested in when Christ is going to return. In fact, it seems like they're concerned about when Christ is going to return, but they shouldn't have been. You know, the Spirit had already provided everything they needed to know. And Paul said not to get caught up in the rest. Everything we need to comfort and edify one another is revealed to us. And that's plenty to keep us satisfied. So don't root your faith in your curiosity about what the Bible doesn't say. That's just going to give you a shaky foundation. We can come here every day. We can talk not just for 10 minutes, but for hours, and we'll still be finding new ways to understand and apply God's word based on what it actually says. That is what we need to grow strong roots into. And that'll do it for this episode of Rooted Daily. And I'm looking forward to sitting down, studying God's word with you next time. Thank you so much for stopping for this episode of Rooted Daily. It is so important to take a few minutes to root ourselves in Christ and in his word. I'm so glad you did it with us today. If you think that it's important that others hear this good news, make sure to hit the share button and subscribe to the podcast on your favorite app. It helps us reach more and more people with the message of Jesus every day. Most importantly, if you're ready to take the next step, repent, be baptized, and hand over your life to Christ, shoot me an email to brandon@rooteddaily.com right now.